Robert Rauschenberg, The Gap Between Life and Art. Milton Ernest Rauschenberg, who later changed his name to Robert Rauschenberg, as we famously know him today, is an American artist from Port Arthur, Texas. His hunger for a more colorful, inventive life ventures Rauschenberg to many places where he gains inspiration into the development of his unique art style. Places like New York was well equipped with street material, such as tires and metal, and garbage in alleyways. He practically utilized everything from quilt to canvas, and three-dimensional materials would become art. His works were linked to neo-dadaist, but as his unique styles of collaboration in the use of silk screen process on canvas is later known to be an important precursor of pop art. The neo-dada manifestations of Rauschenberg are routinely referred to as an intermediary step between the fully articulated abstract expressionism and the similarly complete art of pop. His style of talent came during a time when abstract expressionism dominated the art scene. Unfortunately, his art was misinterpreted and criticized for a long time before he achieved recognition. Rauschenberg's inventions have largely helped to change contemporary optics. His introduction into new ways of approaching and juxtaposing matter has altered the artist's and the layman's reaction to nature. Rauschenberg is known to be one of the greatest artists of all time. Although possibly one of the most misunderstood, this may be because of some of his greatest pieces, such as the Monogram, 1955-1959, or Canyon, 1959. The combined series, which were part painting and part sculpture. As historic as these pieces are, in this video I'd like to focus more on his many other brilliant expositions. With similar use of natural compositions, glass, metal, wood, and other man-made materials, he creates art out of just about everything. One of his most controversial works would be Erase, Der Kooning Drawing, 1953. Rauschenberg loved drawing and wanted to include drawing in his series. He wanted to incorporate the eraser and showcase the art in subtracting from a piece versus adding to it. When it comes to drawings, the eraser is a fundamental tool. Essentially, Rauschenberg drew, then erased his own piece, but felt it would just be Rauschenberg and doesn't tell the story he intended. He then thought in order to formulate the art behind drawing and erasing, it must start off as a masterpiece. He devised a plan and went to one of the greatest abstract artists of all time, Willem de Kooning himself. It may have benefited him that most abstract expressionist painters did not take Rauschenberg very seriously. Rauschenberg explained his idea in request for one of Kooning's works, so that he can reverse it as a form of artwork within itself. Kooning wasn't for it, but understood Rauschenberg's vision. He then gave Rauschenberg one of his drawings, ensuring that it was going to be tough to erase.
He gave me something that had charcoal, oil paint, pencil, crayon, and I spent a month erasing that little drawing.
Although most critics at the time took this offensively as an act of revolt against abstract art, it was considered poetry to Rauschenberg. At first glance, most viewers couldn't see nor understand how this was even art. Some felt that he robbed us of one of the greats, de Kooning's art piece as well. But with a better knowledge behind the meaning of this brilliant, explicit thinking artist, Rauschenberg, he truly shows us that art is in the eye of the beholder. Art can be the meaning of the process in which it takes to create the masterpiece. Rauschenberg goes on to challenge himself in many different art forms, such as performance arts, in in his hugely anticipated Pelican Act of 1963 and opened score in 1966, which took 9 evenings to perform. In 1964, Rauschenberg became the first American to win the International Grand Prize in painting. It was the 32nd Esposizione Biennale in Venice, and he receives many other awards throughout his lifetime. He collaborated with various other artists of different expertise and combined anything he could think of that tested the boundaries of life. Even bringing technology and art together in his Mud Muse 1968 to 1971 expose. Rauschenberg spent generous amounts of his fortune in humanitarian activist movements in his Rocky expedition overseas. He named this project Rocky after his pet turtle. He wanted to spread peace through his art. He settles in Captiva, Florida for the remainder of his years, where he passes due to heart failure in 2008. Rauschenberg's prestigious life will continue to live on